Mom, Dr. Hernandez wants to study me.
No, Kevin. He wants you to participate in a research study.
Do you think I should do it, Mom?
Let's talk about it at dinner, Kevin.
Our first specimen will be the Kevin.
Dr. Hernandez asked Kevin to participate in a research study. All Kevin needs to do is answer some questions about his asthma and provide a little extra blood next time we go in for his regular blood work.
How much extra blood do they want?
Good evening, Kevin.
You've got plenty.
Dr. Hernandez said about an extra teaspoon.
That's not much, but it's up to you if you want to do it.
They want to study your blood to learn what causes asthma. The doctors will ask some questions to find out how the asthma affects you. Even if you say no, Dr. Hernandez will still take good care of you.
I wonder what medical researchers really do. Hey, Mom, what do you think about using medical research as a topic for my science report?
Don't see why not. Your Aunt Barbara was in a research study when she was a teenager. You can interview her. I bet Dr. Hernandez would be happy to talk to you, too.
So, what's the study about, Kevin?
He wants me to help researchers find the cause of asthma. I'll be famous.
For discovering the cure for asthma, I present you, Kevin, with the Medal of...
Kevin, I don't think you're going to become famous by participating in this study. Right, Mom? You and a gajillion other people are participating in this study.
Kevin, people don't become famous by being in studies. Doctors keep patient names and information private.
What is a medical research study, Dr. H?
It is how we learn, Sophie. Research helps us identify causes of illness and develop better treatments. There are many different kinds of research, Sophie. Sometimes we ask people to answer questions. Sometimes we gather samples from patients. Other times, we ask patients to test new medications. One of my assistants drew this nice chart that shows the different types of studies. Surveys, sample studies, and drug testing studies. I am asking Kevin to take part in a research study where he answers questions about his asthma and we get a blood sample at the same time.
What will you do with the blood once you get it?
I am going to send it to a lab worker at a university who will measure levels of substance in the blood called a protein. We will compare what we find in children with and without asthma.
What about the questions that Kevin answers, Dr. Hernandez? How does that help you understand Kevin's asthma?
Here's my colleague, Dr. Ling, to better explain that, Sophie.
Hi, Sophie. I worked with Dr. Hernandez to write the questions that Kevin will answer. Mostly, we want to know how his asthma affects his ability to go to school and exercise, and what medications he takes.
There is a whole team of researchers involved in this study, Sophie. They include doctors and nurses who care for patients and conduct research, lab workers who analyze blood samples, researchers who develop questionnaires, statisticians who use computers to figure out what the results mean.
We never know what we'll find, but we hope the information we gain will help us learn about an illness. We want to make life better for children like Kevin who have illnesses.
How many questions are in Kevin's survey?
40 questions, 445.
We tried to keep surveys as short as possible so we don't bore people. This one has only 20 questions.
Normally, it's very hard to get into one of these buildings, but my friend Annie Weber works here.
We do a lot of background work on medications before we begin medication trials in people.
Trials?
Clinical trials are another name for drug research studies. To figure out if medications work, we usually need to compare two groups of people. Here's an example. In this study, we asked 20 patients to take drug A for 1 month and another set of patients to take drug B for a month. At the end of the month, 19 patients who took drug A felt well, but only 2 patients who took drug B felt well. That's why we think drug A works better than drug B.
Are you always comparing 2 drugs?
Not always. Sometimes one group of patients takes a drug while the other takes a pill called a placebo. This is a pill that looks the same as the drug we are testing, but has no medicine in it.
What if patients in the study get sicker?
Great question, Sophie. New medications can sometimes have unexpected effects.
Wow, I have spots.
That's why patients in drug studies are monitored very closely. It's the job of the research team to make sure participants are safe.
I thought you might like to ask Aunt Barbara some questions for your project, Sophie.
I was part of a study about teenage diets. All I had to do was answer a bunch of questions about what I was eating. Ramen noodles, broccoli, Pop-Tarts.
Did you learn anything from the study?
I got a letter from the researchers after the study was finished. They told me that teens who eat vegetables and exercise regularly are more likely to stay thin. I still try to eat healthy.
Don't forget exercising and drinking plenty of water.
Mom always tries to make me eat healthy foods.
Kevin is doing really well. Dr. H asked him to participate in a research study. Now that we all understand, we're going to sign an informed consent document today.
Bryce is doing well too, but we've decided not to participate in the study. Dr. Hernandez told us that whether or not Bryce is in the study, Dr. H will provide the same medical care. We need to leave right away so Bryce can make a soccer game.
Have fun at the soccer game. I'm going to read the consent form now.
Do you have any questions?
I have to sign the consent form, Kevin, but you should sign it too.
I've decided to take part in your study, Dr. H.
Extra, extra, read all about it. Kevin cures asthma.
I hope your research will help you learn about asthma and maybe help other children.
Thanks for doing this, Kevin. I'll let you know if we find anything, but that won't be for a while.
Don't forget to label that for the study. I don't want that sample to get lost.
I did it! I got an A on the medical research report.
That's wonderful, Sophie.
All thanks to me.
Maybe in a few years, my guide to medical research will be published so everyone can understand what medical research is.
Oh, Sophie!